Hello, this is Close Look, Anjan Arai with you. We're here with Talvin Singh. He's a producer, a composer, and a tabla guru. He's here in Vancouver, so we get to have a chit-chat with him. Hello, Talvin.
Hi there. Hi. I don't know about the guru. I'm still learning, right?
You're still learning?
Yeah, of course I am.
Okay.
It's a big ocean out there.
Absolutely. So can we start off from when you started? London, England is where you were born and raised.
Yeah, London was where I was born, and then I kind of spent a lot of my childhood in India as well with my master. So I became like a student of his when I was like 15. So that's been a beautiful journey in my life as well, to have somebody, you know, as great and giving and loving as on a complete unconditional level, you know. So that's been a big blessing in my life to have that.
Absolutely, and that's a lot what this show is about, because when you are a kid and you're trying to figure out, you know, what your passions are and what you're doing, how did the music scene and the tabla and you going to India to learn more about music, how did that all come about?
Well, you know, I started collecting records like at very, very early age, like 11 years old. I remember the first record I brought was called Smurfs, and it was like I don't know if you know it, but I heard it recently, and you know, it was this kind of electro kind of record. And then the day after, I went to this place called the Punjab Record House, and I said to my dad, a friend who owns this place, and I said, but I want to go there. So I brought like an Indian classical record, Ustad Vilayat Khan record, just because I felt like, you know, there was a certain mystique about these musicians and the way they kind of were just engaged with their instrument, just in the photograph. And I was like, yeah, this is cool, man. Like, you know, look at this guy. It's like, he's really, you know, seems like on another space.
Because a lot of people call you the father of Asian underground as well, because you were able to bridge classical music with electronica and drum and bass and all this kind of stuff. So, you know, how did your mind start thinking, you know, classical is classical, electronica is electronica. Where did all this, you know, infusion come together?
Right. Well, I think, first of all, that, you know, the kind of the exchange in music has been happening for a long, long time. You know, so I was influenced by that. So I wouldn't say I'm like the father of any scene or...
Come on, toot your horn. I'm like...
Yeah. You know, because it's... You know, what I'm saying is there's this whole kind of anthropology of music. And it's us which actually divide. There's this music, you know, it's all connected. I mean, you look at North Indian music, you look at Punjabi folk music, the Sufi music, you know. It's a big mashup of like Iranian, Persian influence, Turkish music. So everything's a big... You go to South India and the percussion, the drum tradition seems more like African tradition. I found very, very fascinating when I really started kind of seeing how some Indian musicians engaged, and I could spot the ones which had this openness to engage, to cross over, and like a tabla player to play with a saxophonist, and it's just like, this is music. And there was a set of Indian musicians which I felt they didn't have the ability to do that, or the openness to do that, but they were great musicians. I discovered that when I was very young, and I was interested in the culture of that on a complete you know, scientific level, in a way of like, what is this? How comes one person is open enough to be a little more worldly about the repertoire of music, and then the other isn't? And I started getting into that idea, and it helped me open, you know, my kind of horizon, and helped me be myself too.
Have your parents always been very supportive of you?
Yeah, my dad called me earlier, which was really nice. I spoke to my dad, I spoke to my mom, you know, my sister. Yeah, they've been supportive, but I mean, support in the kind of, they're just like, whatever you do, you just, you know, you got to nurture it and you got to do it well, you know. So that was the kind of support and the kind of ethic, I suppose. But other than that, you know, I left home when I was like you know, 14, 15, I was out on my own, man. And so I had to really kind of learn from my mistakes.
That is interesting, because obviously music consumed you and that was your passion. But could you see yourself doing anything else, or have you tried to try other ventures in, when it comes to career or passion?
You could sit me down, you know, with my drums until the cows come home, and I don't budge. I'm like, I'm happy here. So that's my first love. I love playing, and I'm lucky I have that, because it's also yoga. To play an instrument is, you know, it's a very physical thing, playing drums. That's why I really encourage it.
You're very insightful. I probably could speak with you forever because there's so many topics, and you've done so much, and you are such a role model to the younger generation, you know, looking up to someone like you. What is some advice you have for them?
I mean, my advice is always just to keep it real, you know, just try to. I think in this business, you can, you know, you're kind of, you're so passionate about what you do, and then all of a sudden it becomes like about achieving certain goals, or, you know, selling a certain amount of records, and you can easily just jump offline, and then all of a sudden it happens to a lot of artists, and all of a sudden you're like, well, am I still enjoying this? You know, so I think it's important to really know what you want, you know, as far as like what food you want to eat or what clothes, and just really stick to it and enjoy it, you know, enjoy that, and make sure you let everybody around you know that you're having a great time. I think it's important to be very, very strong about what you want to do, and stick to that and really enjoy it and get better at doing that.
Thank you so much, Talvin Singh. He says, keep it real. This is Close Look.
Hi, this is Talvin Singh. You're watching Close Look. Get inspired.